Hey, my name is Kyle Winborn, and I look like an idiot because I'm using this PlayStation headset because apparently my laptop microphone is broken, but the video quality is shit anyway, so let's get into it. My name is Kyle Winborn, and I'll be talking about a couple different studies my classmates and I conducted in our research methods class at St. Edward's University in the fall of 2017 with Dr. Farrell. For the first study, we wanted to measure how passive and active social media use affected psychological well-being. Psychological well-being can be split into positive emotion, negative emotion, and life satisfaction. Active social media use involves posting and interacting with their social media feed, and passive social media use is just simply opening the app and reading the posts and not making any posts. But I hypothesized that active social media use would negatively correlate with life satisfaction. But anyway, for the study, we created a Qualtrics survey and posted it on all of our social media accounts, resulting in 455 participants, which is pretty damn good, I think. But we used the scale of positive and negative experiences, otherwise known as the SPAIN test, along with the Satisfaction with Life scale, which is SWLS. But what we found was hours spent using social media passively were negatively correlated with life satisfaction. But besides that, no other significant relationships were found. Of course, the maintenance thing starts going off. But for the second study, we wanted to look for the causal relationship of positive emotion and active social media use. And I did not create a hypothesis for this study as it was an exploratory study. But our number of participants was considerably lower than the first study, and we only got 54 participants. I think it was 13 male, and the rest were female. But participants answered questions relating to the SPAIN and SWLS scale, but we also used the Velton scale to determine if one's changes in moods will cause a participant's change in social media use. What we found was mood or affect does cause active social media use, but no other relationships were found besides that, including gender-specific relationships. We didn't find anything. But what does all this mean, I guess? Well, our studies are of great relevance in today's world because a reported 90% of adolescents ages 13 to 17 had used some form of social media, and that's a pretty big number, but obviously adolescence is a time of brain development and should therefore not be taken lightly. But study one was important because, now more studies can be made to examine the relationship between passive social media use and poor reported life satisfaction and see, like, what's all that about. But study two is important because understanding what causes people to use social media is an important factor in figuring out why it's abused so much as it is today. But, yeah, that's about it. Like, comment, and subscribe.